let's get started. People can join in. There's a little bit of boring PowerPoint exercise in the beginning, but then we'll get started really soon with some code. So first of all, hi, welcome to the Start with Bolt and Go Easy session. So first, maybe you don't know that much about me. So I'm Jani Tarvainen. I'm Finnish, not finished. I work at a company called Exalt in Finland. I do a bit of everything. I work with web development, web server hacking, SEO analytics, anything I'm interested in. And if you want to have some discussions pretty much about anything, I'm always interested in things like Commodore, Digital Equipment Corporation, Alpha Processors, Demo Scene, websites built with frames and layers, web components, Google Knowledge Graph, HTTP 2, build clusters, whatever. I don't know maybe that much about them, but I'm always interested in talking about all kind of things. There you can see the Twitter handle, so that's Velmu. Maybe you've seen, might have seen that in some places. Then, short, shameless plug from my employer. So, I work for Exalt, which is an originally Finnish company, 10 years old or so, around 70 people. We develop all kind of web services, technology, design also. We have a broad technology mix, so we don't just work with EasyPublish and PHP. We work with all kind of things, so mostly Word or PHP and Node. And then it's quite a nice place to work for, so we've been awarded as one of the best places in Finland to work. So if you are interested, we are hiring, always good people. So we have offices in Finland, Estonia, and the UK, and multiple locations available. And because I am also the I guess the ambassador of Finnish code here, I'd also like to remind you that my tax dollars paid for Linux development originally, IRC, SMS, Doctrine was also originating Finland, so it's a good place to code and things like that. But that's it for the business bullshit. So, most of you are here today probably because you are either Symfony PHP developers or EasyPublish or Easy Platform developers. Today I will introduce you something called the Bolt CMS. It's a CMS, so it is a system to manage content with. It's built with the Silex framework. So if you're familiar with that, many people are. So it's built with Silex. It doesn't obviously have any defined structure by Silex. And then it is quite new for you know, LAMP PHP CMS, so 2012. So it's not that old. But obviously it's building on Symfony Components, all kind of you know, code. So there is very mature bits and pieces in there. So it's not built from scratch in 2012. So it's kind of very similar in many cases maybe to WordPress, because it's really simple to get started with, really simple to work with, instant gratification kind of thing. So it's very fast. And it's kind of like Easy in the sense compared to, let's say, Drupal. It's that it's quite a complete package. So you install it, you have all kind of things already inside. Then obviously you can have extensions and so on. But the system in its basic installation is already very usable for a lot of things. So it is very easy to install. Again, if you think about WordPress, famous 5-minute install, it's kind of like that. By default, it uses the SQLite database, so you don't even need any database credentials or anything like that. The extension, there's a extension marketplace. I kind of like how it's done. So it uses Composer, exposes that to the browser. So you can see the Composer installation in the browser. So that's kind of a nice thing for me, and maybe, you know, We'll see about that. So a few more things about Bolt CMS. So it is, in my opinion, very good for developers. So the developer experience is very good, in my opinion, at least for somebody who is versed in modern PHP, easy publish Symfony. There's very little overhead of learning anything at least specific to Bolt. But there is still, like, for end users, you create menus in YAML. That's maybe not something that customers will want to do. Obviously, you could have some extension for that. But anyways, there's still some places where it's not optimal. And obviously, it is quite young, 2012. But I think it's quite solid because it builds on not Doctrine ORM, but DBAL and so on. And the documentation, it's quite good, even though there's some version mismatches and so on. Then I already said that installations installed via admin using Composer. And then one last thing. So Bolt CMS is mostly developed. Well, it's an open source project, obviously, but in the larger part is some company called Two Kings from the Netherlands, who mostly developed in it. At least, I mean, full time. There's a few guys who develop it a lot, and then there's kind of other contributors as well. But they provide some commercial support and so on. So let's move forward with Easy Platform and Bolt. So what's shared with them? So they're both modern PHP applications. So there's very little overhead of if you compare again to WordPress, you need to kind of invest in the WordPress way, which is still in a sense that it's very specific to WordPress. But if you've been working with Easy or other Symfony apps, then you'll be quite at home probably very soon. So there are shared component or shared ideas behind content management systems. So it also has a flexible content model. Both are somehow using Symfony components, other PHP components. Symfony is just a very known brand, so that's why I mentioned that a lot. But there's obviously other projects as well, giving to use all kind of things. So obviously configuration formats are the same. So you use a YAML, you'll just edit YAML, and that's what you do. Then there's parts like the console. It also has a console, so it feels very similar to any other Symfony. I think it uses the Symfony console component. And then there's conventions, how you, namespacing, autoloading, installation via Composer and so on. That's all very, very same. And then one very big thing, obviously, especially if you come from a background with, let's say, WordPress, Drupal, or Easy Publish, they all had very custom templating side. Obviously, Easy had its own templating language. Then Drupal had some functions, PHP, which you had some, Drupal 7 had the preprocessors and whatnot, and you had to learn that. But Bolt obviously uses Twig as well, so that is very lingua franca maybe nowadays for many developers, so that's one thing. So then let's quickly go through about Bolt. So I'm not really a Bolt. I've done some patches, so I'm not like the Bolt guy. I have used it. What I do like about it, it's very quick to get up and running. So I wish really Easy was this easy, because obviously it's in many cases it's not. So we'll see how to install it, so on, very soon. It's not a very common household brand, so nobody calls the office and says, I really need some Bolt now. It's more like I really need some WordPress now, because many customers really, you know, they come with a brand and they already want to buy some brand of product. It's the same as you go to sunglass shop, I want some Ray-Bans. It's the same kind of thing that even though, you know, you might have very good technology or something, that's the brand still is, it's a big factor. I don't like how the default themes are built. They use sort of kind of, I don't like they include header and footer. They don't use the extending of the layout, but that's something that we can change. So that's something which I don't like. So I've been running a Bolt. I currently run three sort of hobby sites with it. Originally, I installed it in 2013. It's been very solid. There's not much surprises. It's performant enough. So with default configurations and all, I did some trolling. I've managed a few times to get on Hacker News front page and Slashdot front pages. It works fine. And obviously, if you need some easy way to move forward, you can use things like Cloudflare to cache things. But it is not, you know, the first problem that, you know, you install it and then five people show up and it slows down. I've also experimented with it. I'm running it with HHVM and the H2O web server, which is an HTTP2 web server. It works just solid with that combination. So it's not just, you know, PHP, Apache kind of thing. Then by default, it uses SQLite. So transitioning from one installation of Bolt with SQLite is not straightforward. Obviously, if you've done it before, it's easy. There's some transformations that you need to do, but there's no good documented way of upgrading from the Bolt installation or SQLite installation into MySQL, for example. I don't even know how well it supports Postgre or other databases. I've only used MySQL and SQLite. Upgrades from older versions, I used to run 1.something, but now it's 2.x. The upgrades are quite smooth. So you run Composer, update, and then, well, you know, the semantic versioning you check out, and then there's the console, which you can use to upgrade the database tables. You can use the console or the GUI itself. So first, before we get down and dirty, have a quick look at the admin interface on a website that I run in production. So it's called Symfony FI, and this is the site that I run with HHVM and so on. This is the default theme, so you can see it's quite simple. I haven't really modified it that much. I have some comments from Discuss and things like that. This is what I've been running since early June. The site is pretty much articles, and then there you have some pages. You can see that it's actually showing all the pages because it's the 404 page. It uses this as a template, so that's kind of silly. Then, in addition, I wanted Finnish content, but it's not very good at multilingual stuff. So I have a separate content type for Finnish content, and then you have relations, so I just relate to content items. So that's something that it's not good at, and I don't know, maybe it shouldn't even be. But that's it for the site itself. Nothing to write home about. Search, I guess, works, H2O. Let's see if it finds anything. I don't know if that's some old stuff. It has some kind of search. But the beef is obviously the admin interface for you guys. So the thing about Bolt is that the administration interface is as stands here. So it it's very close to, let's say, I'll use the WordPress example again, because here you have your left sidebar, you can collapse it, expand, whatever. Then you have your content types here, you have content, you have entries, then I have this finish, which is artikkelit. Then you have pages, which is just one type of content. Then you have, for more details, you have configuration. So it does have a permission system. I haven't used permissions extensively, so I don't know exactly how good they are. I do know that you can add roles and permissions, but I've been mostly using it for myself, so I don't have any experience with that. The main configuration is here. So most of the things that you can even see my MySQL password there. Most of the things are configured in this YAML file. I guess, is this maybe some ACE editor or something? Because this is some YAML code editor. Well, I mean, we'll get to see how it works soon. But most of the configuration is here. There is currently no multi-site stuff. So if, for example, I run three sites, I run three times the code, which is some overhead, yes, but that's it. Then a lot of the configurations are very similar to this one. You have content types, which is probably something that's very interesting to you. So you can create, and you will create new stuff here. So you can create a new content type. Here's the one I created for Finnish. So you give it a name, an identifier. Then you have the name, which is artikkelit. Singular name is one article. Then fields, you can copy fields from another using YAML. Then you have relations, so you can add relations from one type of content object to another, which I used translations for. Then you have some taxonomies, so you can have you can define elsewhere some categories and so on. Then you can also define entries and so on, listing records, default status, is it published or draft by default. Versioning is not something that Bolt does. I've noticed that I actually need versioning, because many times I've started writing some article and I've edited it. Then I have another instance, a browser somewhere else, and I edit it, but then I save the wrong version, so then I have I had to rewrite some stuff. So versioning is actually very important, I've learned. It's definitely something that's missing. But as for content field types, you can then see here that there's text, integer, float, geolocation, image, list, image, file list, video, HTML, blah, blah, blah. Pretty much the same kind of stuff that you would have in Easy Publish, except that you configure them with a YAML file, so on. So that's very similar. Taxonomies is you can define certain kind of tags, tag structure, and then you have full free tags. I haven't worked with these that much. Then you have the menu setup, which I said the default one is not very good. So if you see this, this is the menu I have here. So you have a YAML to edit that, which is fine for me, but not fine for my mother, maybe. Routing setup, so you can configure additional routes, controllers, so it is extensible in that sense. Then you have the check database, which check the integrity of their database. You can also add some dummy content, which you can do soon. Then what else is there? Change log, system log, yeah. Then there's file management, so uploaded files, it has management. So you can see that this is the default set of images, I've uploaded some, I can create directories. These are just files in the file system. View edit templates, I don't really use, for example, Symfony file, I don't use, I develop straight to production using because it's my hobby project, so I use directly the online editor. I add things here, and this is the twig. You can see they use include header twig. I'd rather use page layout, extend, and so on. but this is obviously also a matter of taste on whether to use extend, but everybody uses extend, and I like blocks more than I do this kind of thing. But anyway, so you can do that, and I frequently do edits using this. Translations are here, so it has multiple, the admin interfaces in multiple languages. I've translated it into Finnish, but this is mostly string translations, and it's always one language, as far as I know. Then the extension part is view, install extensions. I have a few extensions here. So as you can see, it was loading Composer or something there. I have a few of these extensions. They have a repository where it can pull things. Then I can search for RSS. The search is a bit not my favorite one, maybe. But then you can see the installing package. It's running Composer because normally, RSS aggregator. I don't know what this is. I won't install it to production. I'm not that crazy now. So I won't break that one. We'll do that quick. So you can install packages. You can uninstall, configure, so on. Then also in the extras, there's the menu editor, which I tried, which was totally shit. It's kind of a YAML editor, WYSIWYG kind of thing. Well, I don't know. You can see it. Because it basically just you edit things and then it what is that word? Well, anyway, it turns it into YAML and so on. And then there's configure extensions. Here I have some configurations to my extensions that I've had. Redirects is one good example, very, very common. So you can add new redirects here. So I add a new line for the key and from to I change some article name so it doesn't do it automatically. So anyway, that's pretty much all there is to Bolt in my view, well, my limited view at least. That's it. If we jump back to the slides, if we go back. So maybe we'll share that one later. So if that is it, and this is still Easy Publish summer camp, so it's about Easy Publish, not about Bolt and how it will be the best for everything, because there is no best CMS, there's just many different ones. When would I need to switch to Easy or upgrade maybe, and how to do it and why? Because let's say for Symfony FI, Bolt is just fine. Technically, I don't need it. It is very simple, and I think it should remain simple, because if you add features to the Easy platform level, then it will be more complex. It won't be so straightforward. There will be more, you know, common or harder domains it's trying to fix. So there's no multi-sites. Multilingual is possible, but it's kind of hacky because it's kind of like a Drupal 7. Obviously, you can do. I've done multilingual sites, but it's Drupal 8 tries to work on that, but in my experience, it's Easy from LAMP CMS is Easy is still the best multilingual concepts, and I mean it's there. You don't need to worry about having an extension which is not supporting translations and things like that. Obviously, you can create, but it's still something that I, you know, would rather install that or go with Easy. If you start extending it, then it will be master of all things, and maybe, you know, it will be complex and not what I like it to be, which is very simple and fast. So I'd like the guys to keep it sort of fun, Compared to WordPress, I think it's a better system to learn programming in, because WordPress has a lot of baggage. It's early 2000 PHP code in many places still. So if I want to somebody to learn a new CMS from scratch, I would recommend this one. It will teach you how to develop with modern PHP and so on. But obviously WordPress is a very powerful tool. It won't go away, it shouldn't go away. So that's not like anti-WordPress kind of thing. So anyway, here, then going back, so what about integrating Bolt and Easy? So both tools are actually CMS, content management system. So I wouldn't go and try to integrate two different CMS. If I would have, I don't know, forum software or kind of CRM system, then I could maybe think about using a stack PHP or something to integrate two different software together. But with Bolt and Easy Publish, I don't see the point personally, because if you have content management system, why have two different content management systems? So you could use it maybe for some cases that you need something very fast, and then for some like blogs, the interface might be friendlier to users and so on. But I would rather go with the route of starting with a Bolt installation and then upgrading it completely to Easy Publish. So it's kind of leaving Bolt behind, but with the common template syntax, all of that, it's not as difficult as it could be in other cases. So here's some things where you need Easy Publish. So multilingual, I said it 55 times or something. Multisite installations, said that 25 times. Versioning, said it at least once. Content hierarchy, so it doesn't really have a sort of tree structure, which I'm very much a tree hugger, so I like content trees. I don't like a big bunch of content, I like trees. Advanced caching, a lot of things that you create, you can create a website with MS Word and save as HTML, but it's not exactly the same as creating, I don't know, some online TV service, So anyway, and then when you have larger development teams, then you need structure for people to be able to work together in the same direction. Because with Bolt, maybe you have, for example, the template structure is their preferred version of things or the way that they work with it. So it does still, the Symfony 2 framework or 3 framework does give you structure and direction for the whole team, which is something that I value a lot, because it has some overhead, but it still keeps things more or less uniform. And then, maybe integrating with other data, other models. You might want to push some content to MongoDB from Easy Publish using triggers and things, and then access that using Node, some kind of online or real-time token generation or something like that, where PHP is not maybe the best tool. So Node might be a good tool for some things. So one thing that I don't present to you today, but I will do in any case. So since a lot of the concepts are very, very same and I actually need to do this for myself, so I just call it Bolt to Easy Bundle. I don't know if it will be that. So I will create a bundle that will migrate content from Bolt to Easy, because I know both systems adequately enough to be able to make that. I initially thought I'd create some kind of kludge to make it, but I figure I'll just create something more of a general purpose. So not now, but I will need other people's input on what is valuable, what's not. Because initially I thought I will create a bundle that you install in Easy Publish. Then it will import and convert content types from one system to another. Then it will also do the same for content. So I won't even go as far as importing all the images or whatever. I'll begin just with a content transfer, which already will be very useful for me. So I thought that the command could look something like PHP Easy Publish console, bolt to Easy import model, or and then environment site access would be the admin site of mine, which will then map to the Easy Publish content repository I have, and then the bolt route, you'll just define where is the bolt. Then I will then use, you know, common bits and pieces to read the MySQL database, YAML configurations, and so on. So that's something that you can ask later. And, you know, you have ideas what kind of things you would find useful, because I need to do it for this. I can show you that. So I'm just running this kind of a hobby site, which is because pretty much all the Finnish market is Finnish newspapers always have copy-pasted and translated news from English to Finnish. So I thought I would make it the other way around, because they, you know, the source is, well, I just translated it, so it's my original content. But this is something that I plan to import content into Finnish, and then I can translate using Easy Publish, because now I just manually do this kind of thing. So anyway, this is just one example of what I will use it for. So that's a few sites that it's running and what I plan to do with it. So now, since it's not just talking heads, we'll go to a purely fictional story with advanced agile methods and, you know, all kind of things commonplace in the excellent processes. This will never happen in real life, but hypothetically, it's your first day at work today. You just switched to a company, or your first job maybe, and the background story is that sales has found a golden opportunity to get their shoe behind or between the door of a great client. So kind of if we pull this off, it's going to be big money and awesome references, great stuff, man. So that's what sales is located. And the thing is that it's actually salvaging a blog with a hard deadline. So there's some kind of event or something that they need to have it online. And well, let's say that maybe previous developer didn't know some tool or something that you need to save it. And, you know, as they need estimate in 15 minutes, they call up some developer and there's a developer on the phone and say, maybe you could build it with Bolt or something. So project is sold as Bolt project and with a schedule set by the client. So you're the available resource. So you'll build it. So, you know, project manager forwards you a few emails and templates, and, you know, since it's kind of done by before, so, you know, it should be fast. I mean, it's practically done, so you'll have it by tomorrow, right? So this is what we will get started with. So what I will expect to you is do what you get paid for, so not writing code, but solving problems. So this is the problem that you're solving now. It's somebody's real thing that they need. So it's maybe sometimes silly, but that's what you get paid for, doing silly things. So let's get started. So the idea is, first of all, to install Bolt. You should have the installation on the local, so that is called EasyBolt dot EasySC. Okay, that worked out nicely. Forbidden, why? I just installed it before. Demo effect. But anyway, as it is very nice, I will figure out how to do it. So if you can simply open the well, I had that slide somewhere. So first of all, let's just take a few moments to get started. So the the things that you will need to do is install, create a new content model for blog, whatever you want. Port a raw theme to Bolt. There's an existing theme that we'll check. Then for extensions, we can see the RSS feed and XML sitemap. And for content imports, you can import WordPress extended RSS, which is enriched RSS, proprietary RSS. But if you guys can get started with this. What? Oh, yeah. I think it is. I've had trouble with that, but I thought I will just show you. So in the meanwhile, while I try to fix my setup, if you can open this address, and then there's an installer. So basically, you're starting from scratch. So let me or you installed it. So let's see how we'll get started after the installation. But you can play around with it, and then I will also try to attempt the same golden opportunity that I had. So not. Why you so? Okay, now it's taking a long time. No. Yes. It's back up. Let's see if the site works. Yeah. Okay. So still for development tools, I did mention that obviously you have the familiar debug toolbar. You can see a little bit of the internals of what's going on behind the scenes if you're interested. So that's one thing. So once you are done with the installation, let's go ahead and start. So by default, there is no content. There's nothing here. So first of all, let's just create our new content type. So we'll head over to configuration, content types, and then we'll use the old copy-paste method. We'll just call it blogs or something very similar to what is there already. So I will use my preferred IDE, which is the browser, and I will call this one stories. And if you do need, or let me see if I can, well, it doesn't go that well. So I'll call it stories in my example, and I'll call it stories. Story. Then I'll just slug is the term for URL bits and pieces. Teaser. I'll just take teaser out for now. I won't. Well, maybe I'll leave the head main image there. Then I'll take out video. Let's leave. It can have relations to pages. Let's let that be there. Then let's have taxonomies there, and then let's create, well, let's modify the record templates later, so you have individual templates for individual content types. So let it first be that one, and then you have the same for listing, then you have some, you know, whatever configurations you might want, so it has listing records. Default status for new items, I'll call it draft, so I don't accidentally publish my things. Then it has, again, I think the template just uses records per page. So that should be it. So then let's save. Says not saved. Okay. Is anybody else having some troubles with this? Ah, isn't it just fun when things just work? Except that I think it's this vagrant thing seems a bit slow. Ah, fuck it. I'll create it in production. Never do this, kids. Yeah, so anyway, let's switch to production. It's a better environment. So anyway, let's do the same thing. I will do it in production. You will do it in wherever you want. Local. So, same thing, content types. I'll hit content types. This is running with MySQL database, but that's it. So, actually, one thing that I won't do is that, because obviously with YAML, I learned this while developing this site, so you can reference other fields in YAML. Like this articles, I can copy entry fields, and then it will use entry fields from here as a variable. So that's something I didn't know in YAML before. So you can sort of define that kind of things as well. So I'll create my story. Let's go ahead, create my story. Stories, story. No, story. Stories, story. Yeah, I'll take the entry fields out because that's something I don't need. Here I have the title, the slug, teaser. I don't want no teaser. I like the body, but let's put the body, the height a little bit bigger. I don't want any video. I'll let the article or relation be there so that I will show you how that is edited. All the default templates are there. So anyway, now I save in production. Maybe it saves. Well, maybe it's the Wi-Fi. At least now it says the content types YML has been saved. So obviously now that is defined there, but it's not in the schema or anywhere. So you can do it in the console. So let me SSH to MacGyver.fi. So, you can do it either in the console or in the admin. So if you see the console examples, that's one way. So then you had the check databases in the configuration. It will say that the database fields need to be updated, repaired, blah, 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 do this now. It will actually show this everywhere. You can now see that my stories are here, but it will display this warning, so I will update the database, and now it's there. So now we have the data in the content or there. Probably the default template, since it is in production, but nobody's looking. So yeah, you can see that the default templates. Iterates all the different content types. Now it says the recent story is no recent story. That's cool. So it's working. So let's create a new story or view stories. Let's do that. No stories available. Let's see if I could actually create the. Maybe I don't want to populate production with stupid things. So let's create a new story. This. Don't ever train in production, kids. Don't do it, okay? So there you can see that. Then you can also see that there's this stack, they call it, So you have your image files and things like that. You have it on the stack, so I guess you can somehow select them. I haven't really used it. I don't. They've mentioned it as a feature, but I think it's kind of shit. But anyway, let's move forward. So that's it. Then for media, obviously you have, for example, some like default or main image for your article. So let's see if I can upload something there. Yes, it's the preview. Relationships, these are what I used for content translations. So you have this selector, you could have multiple, and then you select things from here. So that's it. I can say this one, for example. Then taxonomies, it had predefined categories, so let's tag this as love. And then we can have something else as well, summer. Meta is, by default, it's published, which maybe I'll just, I'll keep it. Then you have owners, so I could define different users, IDs, some like internal ID. So then we'll just save that. And you're free to, try to do anything on your own. If you have any questions, please ask. But now we should have our thing here. Yeah, that's very beautiful. This is it. So as you can see, by the way, when I am logged in, the developer toolbar is here. If we have a quick look at the stuff, you can see that it's actually HHVM and I'll have a separate session or talk about the HTTP2 stuff if you're interested. Controller is just, you can add your own. Total time, usage 1 megabyte, so it's quite lean. But DB queries, there's probably a lot of caching that could be done there. And then there's some debugging thing for Twig here. I don't know this one exactly. So anyway, this is what we had. Then if we'll go back to the programming, so let's say now we have our stories, which are the blog entries that our customers will log in and create on a tight deadline. So the next thing is the template conversion. So I have my Visual Studio. So if you head to file management, view and edit templates, and then it lists all the things here. You can see that these are themes. There's the base theme, which is something that is used by default, but it will be overwritten. So we don't want to use that because, any modifications will be removed if you update. Default is, I guess default. Hello is just some test, which I guess I added, tested that it works at all. Symfony.fi is the one I've been using it. I modified it 1 month ago. Let's see how the Symfony FI looks like. So under here you have CSS, images, JavaScripts, SCSS source files. Then most of the stuff is just Twig, but then it also does load config YAML. And then this again just has whatever. As you can see that there's, you can add whatever to your theme. So this is the kind of place where structure becomes important, because if you're working, 10 people working on themes, somebody uses some foobar kind of thing which nobody else uses, so then it becomes more not so defined. It's more of I developed this and it looks like I developed it, not like we developed it. I always like, it looks like, you know, those guys develop it, rather than I know this guy did it because it, his code is always like exactly like this. So anyway, these are some things here that you can define fields or whatever, basically. By default, it defines the header image is random, and it just guesses things from there. Then I think these are mostly quite basic. Let's check the record template. And then let's actually create a new template for stories. So, as well, let's first take a quick look. So, if you have the files here under Easy Bolt theme, Easy Theme, and this is the one that you were supposed to salvage. So, this is just a skeleton kind of thing from a bundle, which is almost done, and so there's not much to it, which might be quite a nightmare in some cases, but in this case, I don't. It's not as bad as it sounds, because if we look at, for example, the full blog front page, for example, here, this is my easy template, so it's quite straightforward for me to start porting this to Bolt. I know this is the other way around that I talked before, but I figure this is a better way because time is limited here. So anyway, this is something that will introduce our easy platform templating methodology in here. So we'll use extensions, and we'll use a block called content for anywhere that's the content. Here, I have some kind of navigation which lists blog posts, so it's very similar to this list. Obviously, it renders a controller. We'll have to see how Bolt does it. So I think there's something called aside. Yes. So on the aside template, which is this area here, which goes through all the content types currently in the system, you can see that for app config get content types, if not CT viewless default false, blah blah blah. So anyway, it just starts iterating through those. So it has the content types, so it really relies a lot on the configuration for picking up this data. And then content types, generic, recent. I haven't actually worked that much with this, so it's also somewhat of a learning experience for me as well. But for records in here, let me see, content type. Recent CT slug, yeah. We loop those and then we get the paths route, which is kind of, to be honest, I think there's a better way maybe to have always the route, somehow some kind of a twig helper for these kind of things. But you can see that it loops those. Then there's an additional thing called about. There's some additional logic that they by default have, such as the welcome to symfony.fi, which is just created in the template that if you have a page called about, then that about page will be listed here in a short thing. So this is the kind of thing that we have. And then if we take a look at back to the easy template, so it's kind of the same. Here we have obviously easy render field, which could be more simple. Let's say, let's check the individual record still. So then we should have the thumbnail value is here. So they have here for what you might have for image rendering or image field rendering. Here they have image source is thumbnail, so it's kind of it's not as abstracted, but it's very quite simple for me, at least as you know, noob developer of Bolt, to see the thumbnail value is 640. So okay, I probably could change that to be something larger. So anyway, this is where it is good and bad, because there's lots of freedom, and this is where, again, I stress structure is good, because if you have too many kind of special things like that, it might be a bit tricky to have. So that's one thing which we could take a look at. Too bad I don't, because I don't want to completely mess up production. So I'm not sure I want to change the complete theme, but maybe we can do some small fixes still. You're free to try to port this this template package to let's quickly check out. So there's blog front page, blog post. And then the default, stuff is quite, it uses skeleton CSS for layout, hard-coded latest posts. Then there's that looping of things, which you can try to practice. Then there's individual blog post. So it again extends the same layout. Obviously, it doesn't have the bundle naming, so you'll need to just extend whatever you want. I also don't like that I think they didn't use .html.twig. I think it uses just .twig. I like having .html.twig because it tells me that this is HTML twig, even though in 99% my twig is HTML. But I've also found it many cases useful to write XML using twig, because then it's just at a glance I can see record.xml.twig. Okay, that's the one I'm looking for if I would like the XML version. But again, that's one sort of preference. And you can see there's some, we render the title of the post, we render the content in the easy template. Then there's commented out some published when and by whom. And then again, latest posts is loops. There's a controller in the back end, which you don't have, but this is the package that the project manager forwarded to you. The main site front page is actually pretty useless. It doesn't exist. Then for parts, I had a rendering for those lift ups on the right. So that is just quite straightforward. For a location, search hits, and it lists and does things. But this is, again, more of your preference to working with things. I will need to also port templates into the metropolitan.fi website. So I will create those templates in the same way as Easy Platform does. So I will call my main content area content and so on. That's, again, something that I have total freedom of doing whatever, but for me, it's easier to standardize on some principles rather than anything, include header, footer kind of things, which is works fine, but I'd rather go my way. So then under default, well, that's just the default thing. Then under public here, I have Easy Finland theme, which you can see. Then skeleton has some CSS framework stuff. Then I had some images here, which maybe I don't even use. But anyway, that's something that I won't now be able to show you, because maybe I won't. Well, let's see if I'll create a thing in there. So anyway, now we've gone through creating content types, how the theming system works. You can just, you know, create files and set the main theme to be something, and then, you know, you get instant results. You don't really need to write any custom controllers or anything like that. If you are interested in that, then under app, SRC, wait a minute, where were they? Controllers, you can see probably the, what was it again, the it's front-end record, so let's see if that was there. Front-end, the controller is here, record. Controller for a single record page. So that's just regular stuff. So it, you pass something and then it will do its thing. If you do want to, you know, in as you can in Easy Publish also easily do, is override the controller for some specific kind of thing. You had the configuration. Then under configuration, you had routing setup. So if you go to into routing, you can see there are some default routes. I haven't worked with routes or these because I've just wanted to use Bolt as a CMS with a focus on content, not features. But anyway, you can see that there's homepage search. Then there's also preview. So you can actually get the preview. I don't think we looked at that. That's actually one content that's not published, sort of a raw thing. So actually, live edit is something that I haven't looked at. It might be good. Let's see if it works. So anyway, this you can get this preview entry. I guess it posts something, or you know, you can get previews like this. Then for live edit, let's see how that is. So okay, this seems to be closed editor. What is this? I haven't used this because I don't like inline editing. Doesn't seem to work at all. Could it be that you need Google browser or something silly? Half price perfumes? This is the browser my wife uses. I don't search for half-price perfumes. Yeah, but here you can actually see the permissions. Now I'm not logged in here. But I don't know. Let's not focus on the live editing thing. But I think it's probably some inline thing which you can have. One thing that Bolt also doesn't have is full REST API. So that's something that you will also want. But now we can actually use that as accidental gateway drug to extensions. I do know that there is some kind of JSON API for this. I haven't used it, but I've heard that one exists. So now this symphony.fi, I want to expose it in JSON. I don't call it REST because maybe it's not technically REST. So again, comfortably in production, we'll go ahead. There's also, the extensions Bolt CM. Bolt store. There's some sort of Bolt extensions here. I haven't used like forms or Bolt BB. Sitemap I have used. But anyway, it's kind of like WordPress is, or plugins for WordPress kind of thing. The menu editor is one we checked, which can't remember now the word, but anyway, just creates JSON format from your menu. So anyway, let's go back to the extension part. Before we do, let's hop back to the main site, which we haven't gone into at all. If you were unable to find Bolt CMS, or Bolt is not a very easy, brand to find with Bolt. There's at least another tool called Bolt for something else. But anyway, Bolt CMS is the best. Obviously, you have the code on GitHub. But one thing I still want to show you, developers also, is the documentation. So maybe you already, saw some pain and then didn't even have any documentation. There is some quite good documentation because there's obviously, as I was able to go through pretty much all the features of the system in quite a short time, so it's also much easier to write documentation for and maintain good documentation for that. But it's still, it's in many cases not done, but there is quite good examples of how things work. So this is something that I would maybe use as some kind of model for some easy documentation also, at the style of writing, and then it's quite good. Obviously a bit different kind of target audience and so on. But one thing that you can also maybe see is Bolt extensions, basics of extensions. So coding your extensions, initialize. There's some things that you write. So this documentation is what I wanted to show you quickly. Then one thing is also which I should have linked to you early in the beginning. So cheat sheet. .bolt.cms. So here you get the details for what you have in the template. But let's go back to the JSON thing. So in our example, we're supposed to have, let's say, the feed and then the sitemap. Symfony FI already has the RSS feed enabled. You configure what you want to expose, how many items and so on, all in YAML. All in browser. Then I also have the sitemap, which generates sitemap, which is fine until how many 10,000 nodes or whatever I have of content. Then I have the Bolt redirector and so on. But let's now see how you install the JSON, or you want to power your application with this headless Bolt, which is some kind of hype in some circles now. But anyway, JSON field type, JSON API, yeah. So I don't like this interface. You have to first click JSON API, then I would expect it to search, but I need to click browse versions. But then you click browse versions, now it's slowly going. To fetch things, yes. So anyway, here you can see stable versions, unstable test versions, and so on. So let's go ahead and this. I think this should again be the other way around, most recent version up, but it's kind of taste also. But I want to go with this 2.0. Then I'm installing package.
That's
obviously a good risk or thing, and the whole application, this doesn't have a document root web. This is all like, if you look at it, I like having a separate root for my web, because here you have Easy Bolt. And then, obviously, it makes it much faster because you have the index PHP here and everything here. So it doesn't have, by default, the slash web, which I would like it to have. But then again, it will create additional, maybe, you know, symlinking that you need to have, and then maybe you cannot, I don't know if you can even FTP anymore, anywhere, but SFTP maybe. But if you want to drop this, that maybe simplifies it. But anyway, it's worth considering. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I understand. But anyway, so here, if we go back to the installing package, we have 15 minutes left. So now you can see loading composer reports with package information, installing Bolt JSON API, writing log files. So now it's done. That's cool. So what do I do now? I've never installed that before. But I have used Bolt before. So what I can do is all in the listing page. Let's see if there's some, you can add new items to the menu, but obviously maybe the JSON API isn't one. But here in the listing page, you always have this config. That's part of the extension that you need to provide. So let's go ahead and see JSON API Bolt YML. So default configuration file for JSON API extension. List the content type you want to serve through the JSON extension. Content types, entries. Okay, that's cool. And there's different kind of thumbnail. You said headers, you said the course headers. Then base URL where the API is accessible. Okay, slash JSON. Well, this didn't, maybe, or a lot of like things which, because it aims to minimize sort of overhead, so it's not always a good thing to enable all options by default. But usually, I mean, to my experience, it does that. But let's see. So JSON API here, entries one. So let's see what we get from JSON entries one. At least it takes a long time. Okay, it gives me something. Yeah, so it gives me some kind of, you know, content in JSON format, which is nice. You can already use this for a lot of things. But obviously, it doesn't, it's really just JSON output, which is fine. So anyway, that was the default thing, but that's not what I wanted. I wanted to expose my stories, not my stuff, or not everything. So you can actually apparently make some queries here. So let's, what was the address again? Symfony FI JSON entries one. So I actually always redirect there, but let's have stories. Stories not found. Maybe it's not enabled because there was that listing of things. So if we go to JSON API config, list fields, okay, entries, let's just go ahead and I don't want, I mean, sure, anybody can scrape my website for my valuable content, but let's see stories. So list fields, so I want to expose only the title field for my stories or my story. So allowed fields, okay, title, where, clause, okay, that then you can also define that they have to be published, which it's kind of similar to the content repository queries that you would write in EasyPublish. I've never done this, so let's do a bit of copy pasta. As you can see, the editor, which whoever, whatever editor it is, I haven't looked into it. I quite like it because it allows you to create YAML quite well. I mean, if I allow fields, or I'll just put title, and then where clause, indentation, status, published. Okay, and let's see. Yes, and let's see what happens. There's a bit of a lag with the network, but now it saved it. Let's see, now we get our articles, the limited things that we have. So that's maybe a few things. Let's go back to reverting to our original state. So let's, we have 10 minutes left. So if you have any questions or anything, ask now or ask later or ask when I'm drunk, when I'm not drunk, when I'm available, go ahead and ask. So one thing that I also, because I'm also, as I told, I've been running for 3 years, but mostly as content, I mean, CMS user, I haven't really been developing anything with this. So there's probably a lot of things that will hit the wall that, damn, you know, I'm not a developer. I'm purely mostly like end user in this case. Like all the layouts, if you take a look at my three sites, one of HHVM OVH, Symfony FI, Metropolitan FI, you know, this is something that I wanted to have content, just write something to troll. So you can see the layout. This, I think, is the original bolt layout. This is original bolt layout. This is original bolt layout with nice, some, I mean, it's ugly, but it doesn't matter. So I'm mostly like content user. From that perspective, I honestly don't like the stack, which was the stack is not a technology stack, but the if I go to stories, then I'll edit this entry, and it's a bit small because it's responsive, but this is the they call the stack. So this is some kind of collection of some images, which looks cool, but I've never really found it any useful. I don't know what you can do with this. Select. Yeah. Anyway, so this is kind of like, from my end user perspective, I can select, okay, I can select this one. What will happen? Now it's on the stack. What will I do? I don't know. Probably, I mean, the one thing that we didn't take a look at is, by default, for some reason, it doesn't allow images embedding, but if you edit some of the editor configuration, then you can add, I mean, images. Like you have access to the media library. In this case, the media library is the media library looks like this. So Symfony FI and then files. So this is the media library functionality. So it works, but obviously versioning, all kind of things, translations, it's just files. It does create like directories for months, but and it's very good for a lot of things, but for, you know, you need still more enterprisey content management for some cases, but for me as an end user, this is
been quite good, but then again, I do have some criticism with the stack especially. But then also one thing I'm not quite sure about is if we go now to undo our bad things, so I will go view install extensions. I don't know about this JSON API thing, so I will just uninstall it. As you can see, that seemed to fail. It's not installed. Well, that seems like some maybe partially implemented feature. Nobody ever wants to think about A, you know, that a user will want to leave your service or you want to uninstall something. It's always you want to install something or add new users, not remove users and uninstall things, because that's so negative. Nobody will ever want to do that. But anyway, so that was like, as anything, there's things to be fixed, which is why I don't like for the Bolt team to thrive to be something, you know, all-encompassing, because then you have so many more use cases, so many more things that will end up taking time from development and so on. So the one thing that was interesting was the if we go to file configuration content types, because obviously it did create tables for the new stories type that I added. So I will remove that. I have no idea what's going to happen. I would imagine that it won't remove the stories from the database. Obviously, it won't do that if I remove it from the YAML and then save it. Obviously, there's something going on. Now it's content types. I can still see it's here, but this one probably loaded with async. So if I now refresh, now it's gone. I no longer have stories, but my stories are still in my database. I don't think it removed the content. So let's see what it actually, because again, I have never removed any content type. I've only added. So let's see if they've taken that into account. Yeah, your database is already up to date. So let's see what, because we didn't actually take a look at the console, so we have 3 minutes to try to see if there would be something in the console which we didn't look. So on the Bolt, so you have PHP Bolt Bing app console, or app nut. Yeah, they call it nut. So it bolts and nuts. You have to have cute names for software these days. Unicorns and stuff. But anyway, so, okay. Uncaught extensions. Low level check. Ah! Okay, so let's see what was here. The app nut, let's see what did it offer me. Available commands, extensions. Yeah, I don't know about the cron jobs. I've never ran any cron jobs with this. I can apparently get and set values for config. This is something probably for the bridge that I would use, maybe. Then there's some database things. Check table database for missing tables or columns. It has some experimental database. So this is actually something that I might be able to use, because it has some things. Database prefill, don't want lorem ipsum in my production. But let's see the check. So app not database check. Ah. Database check. Database is okay. What do you mean Helsinki is invalid? Update. Database is update. So my content database will be littered with that. Let's quickly see. I haven't really even taken a look at the use date, use Symfony FI. So okay, use Symfony FI Bolt. Show tables tabales. So it has articles for my Finnish stuff, auth token, cron, entries, entries.fi, and my stories is still here. So let's first describe stories. What's there actually? So there's slug, date created, date published, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. But anyway, apparently I learned today that there's no cleaning up as I can see. As far as I can see. Anyway, the time is up, so I hope you now at least have managed to install Bolt, because it was supposed to be hands-on, not just me talking and trying to do things which I ended up doing in production, because that's the thing to do. If you have any you know, questions, go ahead. I did share a lot of my thoughts already with something that's nice and what's not nice and so on. You know, maybe once I get the bridge converter built, maybe I'll present that or publish it. Well, I will publish it if I ever get it into good shape. So hope it was useful. You learned something. I did. So have a nice rest of the day. And thank you.